Hi. Today I thought I'll talk about the RTE Act, that is the Right to Education Act. As of now, whatever exists is the 2009 amendment, that is the last one which was made, which says free education to all children between the age of 6 and 14. Last year there was a suggestion that the age limit be extended on both the ends, that is children get free education from the age of 3 till the age of 18, which is a very positive suggestion and which needs to be implemented so that children get education from pre-nursery till grade 12. Now, why is this necessary? I can tell you from the experience I have had, from what I have seen in front of my eyes in the school that I was teaching. See, under RTE 2009, children were admitted from the age of 6, that is when they were to join grade 1. Yes, that law holds good because once upon a time, that is when my parents were still students, children began their schooling only when they were 6 years of age, that is first standard. Now the problem is children, since the past probably 30 years, I can tell you that for sure because I am 30 years old, are going to school from the age of 3. That is, they have pre-nursery, lower and upper kindergarten, and then they go into grade 1. And present day, there are children who are going to play home also, that is before they are 3 years of age. But that at least is not formal education, so let's put that aside. So children have started going to school from the age of 3. Now, when children come in through RTE to a school, when they are 6 years of age, they are expected to be on par with children who have already started their formal education 3 years before. Nothing wrong, absolutely nothing wrong. Now the problem was, most of the schools are turning English medium. Most of the parents want their children to be in English medium, which itself is not such a, you know, welcoming thought. Why not? Why should you shy away from studying in vernacular? Yes, you need English as one of the subjects. You need to know that language because a prospective employer tomorrow may expect you to know that. Okay, let's put that part aside. So now the children have come into school, an English medium school, when the child is 6 years of age. But the parents have no clue about this language, nor do they have any clue about the subjects. Probably they have not been educated at all. My school was very kind enough to arrange for special classes for these children after the school hours. That is one extra period after the others leave. 3 to 3:40, the children who had got admitted through RTE were given special coaching to understand the language, probably the basics, for 1 year or probably even for 2 years. As far as I remember, it was there during grade 1. So now just think of all these children have to learn what their peers have learned for the past 3 years within 1 year with just one period per day, extra one period. And this is similar to the situation of the teachers that we are telling today during the COVID situation. That is, they are building the plane and they are flying it simultaneously. Same thing was happening with those children. Now imagine a six-year-old child, what emotional anxiety they'll be facing when they are not able to do things which their peers, that is their own age group children, are doing with ease, and they are not able to do that. And it is not because of any difficulty with cognition or anything else. It is just because they are not able to catch up because they have begun much later. It's like someone's already started the race and then you're telling these children to begin running and be on par with the rest. Is it fair? Now, another possibility was probably give a separate section to these children, like in the film Hitchkey, and probably, go at a different rate for these children for a year or two. But that again came as a problem because then we are not following inclusion at all. But my question is, inclusion is generally for children who the society considers are having difficulty physically or in their cognitive levels. But they are all starting on par with the other children at the age of 3. But these children have started at a very different level altogether, isn't it? So why do we think that they are not being included and there is segregation in the children? There is nothing to do with inclusion in this case. They should be given an opportunity in such a way that they are first able to cope up with what they have missed out, and then you can of course shuffle when they are going into the next grades and have them with the other children. Ideally speaking, RTE need not even be included in a private school. From what I know now is government says that they will reimburse the private schools for children who are going for free education. But what is the need for that? I mean, use those funds to improve the quality of education in a government school. Give more infrastructure there. Give more training and workshops to the teachers in a government school so that the children can directly go to a government school and learn. There is nothing like sending a child to a government school is something low. You don't need to feel that at all. If we are feeling that, then we should be ashamed of ourselves, isn't it? It is just like a private school X and Y. So will you say if a child is admitted to X, you are depriving the child of education in school Y? Absolutely not. The same thing, right? Government school and private school should be like two separate buildings, that's all. The quality should not be differing. But we all know what the situation is. So first, that should change. Only after that can we talk about RTE admissions here, there and things like that. And I very much appreciate the Telangana government for what they have done. I mean, there were some photographs of the school building that was circulated a few years ago. Absolutely perfect. That's what all states need to learn and implement in their own states as well. So that is all for today. Don't mix inclusion and RTE and things like that, and give them the opportunity in the correct manner. Let them start at the age of 3. Let them, if they start at the age of 3, I think whether it is government school or private school, there is going to be no problem because they will be on par with their peers, right? Yes, so that is all for today.